You take a picture of me right now?
So as Lash's wife takes us a picture of him as we go live here, it's fantastic. I'm holding his beer, posing like a boss, by the way.
Yeah.
And I forgot my cigar, so I'm gonna. But welcome everybody to this edition of Whiskey Gaming, and we got a good crew here today. Bill and Miller back from vacation, yay!
Yeah.
Cloud is in a beautiful summer's day in the UK, which really for me, looks like there's a nice dusting of snow on all the leaves, so I don't know.
It's definitely warmer than it's been for a long time.
I see it,
summer,
man.
Summer is here.
And Lash is back on the couch. On the couch with Lash is the title today's episode. And we have our
McLeod,
new artwork from Digital Blasphemy this week. A little different thing. We're going away from the space theme since we don't talk about space games. Hey, Seuss here. Yo. How you doing, brother? And by the way, for those who are joining us, please feel free to follow the stream if you're not already.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, Mill needs a new pair of shoes. She needs new high heels, so you can always donate to us because a girl needs shoes. That's what my wife tells me.
Oh.
Apparently, girls always need shoes.
I
need shoes too.
And
I've never understood. Milt, could you clear that one up? Because my wife keeps this secret. What is the reason for shoes? Why is there such? I'm getting a look. Why is there such? Like, why is that such an essential element of a women's repertoire or whatever?
I guess I'm not the best person to ask because I don't love shoes.
Ooh. I have more shoes than her.
Yeah, Justin has more shoes.
I can see that.
Justin also watches Pretty Little Liars, so there you go.
Yeah, I watch Gossip Girl, so whatever.
Yeah, Wiz Demand, this is not Nudity Tuesday with Boat because that already happened or didn't happen before us because when we came up to go live, there was nobody streaming, so it's our turn.
Yay.
And we are here every Tuesday. We are here every Tuesday from 8 to 9, so join us. You might have fun.
Yes.
And I have to bring up the show notes, because I actually don't have the show notes up, even though I kind of wrote them half-heartedly.
Damn it, man.
Today because
get your shit together.
I was lazy as shit over the holiday weekend.
Who wasn't?
Yeah, what did everybody do on the holiday weekend? We just kind of sat around, went to the pool. We didn't even go to the fireworks.
I don't want to know what they did. I want to know what our British friend here did while he prepared to leave the European Union.
He posted memes about us filthy, you know, Yanks.
Coincidentally, McLeod, what did you vote?
I voted Remain, so, you know,
he's
everything.
He's in that demographic, man.
There isn't a young guy or old demographic. There's the... like educated and informed, and then there's stupid and illiterate. So
hey, you know the stupid old people.
Yeah, I'm the stupid and illiterate one. So.
The stupid old people, you know, they fought World War II. I'm good with them. All right.
There was a lot. There was actually a lot of people who were a lot of like old, you know, sort of fairly aging kind of populace that. You know, definitely stayed in the Remain camp because of the fact that most of what we were, you know, a part of Europe for was what we fought in the wars for, you know, in World War II for. So, and I do kind of feel like that as well.
I think you just fought in World War II so you could keep France around so you guys could hit on French chicks. I'm telling you.
Very weather attractive, and those nude beaches.
Well, to be fair, I'd rather
your wife is on share the other couch, right?
I'd rather share a border with France than share a border with Germany. So, yeah.
I thought
they have better food and wine. It's just that's how it is.
I don't obviously understand anything about England. I won't pretend to understand anything in England. But the picture I saw of like Scotland, Northern Ireland. And London being the blue and everything else the red looked a lot like Democrats and Republicans and the way they voted. Like,
it's funny because I actually looked a little bit like obviously because I'm kind of a little bit interested in it. I kind of looked a little bit deeper into it kind of thing. it seemed like more the intellectual capitals of the UK were, at least from what I saw, were voting Remain. You know, there were a large amount of London voting Remain. There was Cambridge and that kind of Cambridge area voting Remain. Oxford Remain voting Remain for the most part. You know, certain parts of Manchester voting Remain. I don't know what happened, man. Like, genuinely.
It's terrorism.
Hey, I put it this way. I don't live there. I'm not a citizen. My opinion doesn't matter. Seriously.
That's fair enough. But to be fair, like, we had people in Gibraltar who were voting entirely Remain because, you know, now they have to figure out a way of getting back to the UK or sorting out some kind of new Gibraltar passport or something.
Is Scotland going to say fuck you and go their own way, finally?
They might do.
Nah, I don't think. The EU's never going to accept them independently. Come on, let's be real about it.
No, they might. They might. They'll have to give up things. They'll have to, they'll have to use the euro and this, that, and the other.
Get out of here.
If I had that much, I probably would.
I don't have that much. I'm just betting on margin. What are you talking about? I just sell some play.
All right. So, video games.
Yes, we do need a banner, but none of us are awesome. Actually, I had one, and then I just forgot to put it up. The Mill made one, nice one. And I was rearranging one day, and I forgot to stick it back on here. But yeah, we need something. She did a good job, though.
Thanks.
I'd like to know what everyone's drinking tonight. Bearing in mind, this is Whiskey Gaming.
Well, I am departing from the whiskey since I'm over on this side. You know, I am drinking in honor because last weekend was the Bridgestone Golf Tournament over at Firestone Golf Club, and over there they drink a bucket, which is in a very large glass. A little bit of cranberry, soda, and a lot of vodka with ice and some lime stuff. And it's an awesome drink, and it'll get you messed up, and even my wife drinks it. So that's what I'm drinking.
Yeah.
Looks yummy.
It is yummy. My wife loves it. And it's made with Tito's, just in case you're wondering.
Is there carbonation in there?
Tito. What?
There's like some sparkly in your feed.
Yeah, it's the green screen.
The green screen.
The lighting's just not perfect today. I'm getting a little weird.
But it was kind of cool because it looks like one of those old cartoon, like 50s cartoon mad scientist concoctions with a little bit of bubble.
Oh, yeah, when I held this up because it came forward and did a little feathering with the green screen. Yeah. Usually it's in a styrofoam to-go cup too, a big one, but I don't have one of those.
Nothing wrong with that. What is Mill drinking?
I got some Jameson Black Barrel and the classic Miller's. It's Miller time, all the time. I'll chug for you.
I'm sipping something which I said that I was going to show on the next Whiskey Gaming in light of the ending of one of the best series of Game of Thrones that I've seen so far.
And I haven't seen it.
Oh, yeah.
It's called Martell.
Martell.
Martell Cognac.
Nice. Nice Martell
Cognac. Why cognac?
Well, because that's what it is.
I gotta take...
They had Martell whiskey, then I'd probably do that, but...
Oh, okay.
Who's the man? Where do you want me to send it? Just want me to put it in chat? He wants to know how to make the bucket from Firestone.
The bucket.
By the way, they have the coolest entry to their bar from the men's locker room at Firestone. There's this hidden corner of the men's locker room, and you walk up to it and you wave your hand in front of this little sensor, and a door slides, you know, kind of like Star Trek, you know, slides open. And then you go in, and then as you turn the corner, there's a sensor that opens a door just like it into the bar. So cool.
Hmm.
So cool.
Very nice.
So, yeah. So it's a very cool place to kind of hang out. So, nice. And it's just a couple hours away, so that's why I've been there. So, did we get it when everybody's drinking?
IBC root beer.
IBC? Oh, water. My favorite root beer.
Yes.
Water. Yes. Is she conscious or she's drying out from the weekend, one or the other? I'm not sure.
Yeah. What's Billy drinking today?
I think he said,
Jameson and Miller's.
Because it's Miller's because time, baby.
Because it's you can't just have one. It's like a lazy deal.
Mill's brother actually got me some 120-minute dogfish head, if anyone's ever had that before.
That'll a long, long ago, up. Yes.
So that'll come on for our show soon. Nice.
Mm-hmm. All right. So let's get into it. Video games.
Okay, talk to Lita Slash because I'm going to put a drink recipe in chat here.
Okay. So
let's hear what you bought.
I spent my money on some foolishness, first and foremost. This is probably telling a little bit more about myself than I'm normally willing to share, but I got Stardew Valley.
Oh, nice.
Because in my heart of hearts, I am a 16-bit gamer, and so I find that to be a pretty true interpretation of Harvest Moon or whatever. Enjoyed that. Got Ark. I appreciate finally there is a game. I'm sure it's not the only one. I just haven't done enough research on this, but you poop in the game. You poop. That is a thing. And the first time it came up, I remember hearing the sound of, you know, taking a shit. And I'm like, did I just take a shit? And sure enough, on my little status bar it said, you defecated. And I couldn't really figure out why, and I turned around, and there was a giant go-fuck-yourself-asaurus behind me. And I guess it, you know, it was my reaction to it. It ate me, and that was...
It didn't like that you defecated right in front of it.
I think it was cause and effect. I think my character in the game knew. I wasn't really paying attention. Maybe I was pooping, like, out of fear. I don't know. But I got that. I got Imperium. It's this galactic survival game. Like, you crash land on a planet, and you got to chop down trees and fucking everything. All the survival games, it's like, chop down trees, get some ore. I feel like there's a theme there. And you got to, you know, build your way to get off the planet, to fly to another planet, blah, blah, blah. That was pretty cool.
Nice.
Nothing much else. Can't really think of Watch House. Oh, fucking Roller Coaster Tycoon, because why not?
That's Mill's jam.
Yes, yes. Now, Mill, tell me, how many times have you made the sliding roller coaster that if you don't put the tube part or the enclosed part, it shoots them off?
Yeah. Well, did you get the original?
I got the whole pack, the original 2 and 3. I don't know if I'll ever even play 3. I really just like 1 and 2.
Corkscrew Follies?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. I don't know if I've ever beaten all the parks in the original.
I never have.
Think about it.
No. There's
so many.
I would always get stuck on, like, Evergreen something.
Okay. Was that the little square one?
No, I think that... One was, like, Leafy Lakes.
That was one of the beginning ones.
Yeah.
There was one that you had to play for, like, 4 years or something. It just... Or 7. It took forever.
Okay. I think the one that always stopped me was the one that was right off the highway. And it was, like, this little bullshit-ass spit of land. And you had to make all your roller coasters, like, crazy high and right, like, impacted on each other.
Yeah.
And invariably, I made them way too extreme. And I would just get frustrated with it. Like, all right, it's 11 Gs, so the fuck what? Just deal with it and enjoy yourself. There's a trash can. Go puke in it. Now get out of my park.
My favorite part of the game is when you win and they all start clapping.
Release the balloons and everything.
And they release all the balloons.
They release balloons, yeah. Yay!
It's so cute.
Yeah.
I remember the one park with, like, the racing roller coasters. That one was sick.
Oh. Yes. Was it one based off Cedar Park or Cedar Point?
Cedar Point, yeah. Yeah, with the
They have like a top thrill track one.
Yeah.
Millennium Force. I hate amusement parks. I don't know. I'm just a fucking vagina when it comes to riding rides.
I don't ride roller coasters. I've jumped out of planes. I've jumped out of helicopters. I will not ride a fucking roller coaster. And my wife.
Is it because you've built many roller coasters on Roller Coaster Tycoon?
I don't fucking trust these people. It's a control thing. I'm a pussy when it comes to something that I'm not controlling. Like, if I'm the one jumping out of the plane, I can deal with that. If I'm in this, strapped into this bullshit ass little bar, keeping me from fucking Fabio and that shit, then I don't like it. It scares me.
All right, Wisdom Man, is my mic a little better here? No roller coaster.
Hopefully it's a bit better.
I fucking love roller coasters.
Awesome. I like some.
There's times where I'm kind of like, do I go on it? Do I not? And I like, when queuing it and stuff like that. And then as soon as I'm like on it, it's just like, fuck yeah, let's do this. Let's do this right. It's like straight away.
Oh, McCloud.
Oh, I love King Dakar.
Yeah, there's also Dorney Park right by us, which has Steel Force, which I think for like a minute was like the tallest roller coaster in the U.S., maybe the world, if anyone's ever heard of it. Mill loves Steel Force.
Oh, I do. I never wore a seatbelt and would stand up, so that's questionable.
She's retarded.
Yeah.
Death wish.
What's wrong with you?
I don't know.
Hey, don't...
I've never been on that.
Mill, don't you guys have a cool story?
Oh, God.
Ooh. Let's do the Rosie one.
The what?
The Rosie.
Oh yeah, we saw Rosie O'Donnell this weekend at LBI. Really weird. Just like, we're going to get ice cream.
What's LBI?
Long Beach Island, New Jersey.
Oh, you guys are in New Jersey?
Yep.
I'm from New Jersey. Sorry, go ahead.
Nice. But, nice. You want to tell the story or should I?
You can start.
So she had a bunch of kids with her and we roll up to the DQ to buy some ice cream and her kids are like, oh, can we pet your dog? And I was like, yeah, sure. And then some lady was... which turned out to be Rosie O'Donnell later, but she's like, they were like laughing that she actually asked, and she's like, yeah, you gotta ask or else the dog will rip your face off. And I was like, Jesus.
Like, holy shit.
And then, so we get our ice cream, and we're standing there, and our friends that were with us are like, I think that was Rosie O'Donnell. And like, I didn't really notice, and they just kept talking about it. I was like, where'd she go? Like, let's fucking follow her. But we never did, so we just got our ice cream, ate it, and went back to the house, and then... Mill is like super creeper when it comes to social media, so she's looking at Rosie's Twitter, her Instagram, and wouldn't you know it, fucking Rosie's posting pictures from LBI, saying all this stuff. We actually found the one kid who we recognized that was with her. Handsome Blake was his Twitter name, and we're like, that was fucking him, that was Rosie O'Donnell. So
it started out as like a joke, like we're like, that's her doppelganger, haha. And then we're like, let's check her Twitter and Instagram and see if she's tweeting at the beach. And then we go to her Twitter and Instagram. We're like, oh, she's actually at the beach. And then we're like, oh, shit. She's actually at our beach. That was her.
So you didn't actually say, God, you look so much like Rosie O'Donnell.
I like, did you?
Yeah.
I get that notice.
It would have been funnier if you asked her to sing the national anthem and grab her crotch, you know.
Oh, God.
She did that.
So that's our one.
But that was cool.
It was good.
It's not every day you get to see somebody who's like, star quality, That's really neat, nifty.
Is that what we're calling Rosie O'Donnell now? Star quality.
Yeah, she had some show.
Yeah, a dying star. Fucking.
Sorry. I was being polite after I was mean.
Oh.
I was trying to offset and become neutral again.
Keep his karma. That's what he's doing.
Chaotic neutral.
Yeah. So that's that kind of the player I like to play anyway, chaotic neutral.
Nice. Mm-hmm. Malcolm.
So Blizzard filed another lawsuit against the cheat maker, whatever their name is. Like their sixth lawsuit. We'll see if they win one.
I was going to say, is this cheat maker like in Europe or something? Isn't it not in the U.S.?
They're in Germany, right? And they have five or six lawsuits against them in Germany, one of which I think they just recently lost. And they filed this one in California, and of course they say, we're German, you don't have any oversight.
Exactly.
Still, I'm going to secretly root for Blizzard on this one.
Yeah.
Because they have to, because these companies that make these cheats just drive me nuts.
Have you guys ever cheated in a game, in an online game?
I've used the like infinite money cheat for like The Sims, but I think that's pretty much.
Oh yeah, Rosebud. Gone.
Yeah, Rosebud! Exclamation mark! Semicolon! Exclamation mark!
The extent of my actual cheating in a game goes to, you know, some of those games on the, you know, early Xbox and stuff like that, and PlayStation, where they had God mode kind of things. You know, push the buttons a certain like way, and you have God mode, right? Or enter the code.
Konami code.
That would be about it. And by the way, it was only it wasn't in multiplayer mode, right? It was just in single player mode.
Yeah.
I don't think I'd ever pay for cheats. That's retarded.
No, I don't want to win. I
understand
a game
the
that
appeal.
Bad.
Yeah, and then it's like, okay, well, yes, you used the nuke on the anthill. Good job. You're the fucking winner.
Well, when you look at games like Overwatch, which is the game they filed this latest one on, right? So you look at the game like Overwatch, they're trying to do a competitive mode. So having cheats out there that have ESP, which is this particular cheat they filed against, we know how much fun ESP is to battle against McCloud and Lash, right?
Yes, yes.
And, you know, when you're trying to actually make money on a game and bring it into a competitive mode where there's a lot more money involved in it from a developer perspective, I mean, there's got to be a way to legally go after these folks, right? Lash, you're coming back to H1Z, and we're having a wipe this week, okay? I'm just putting it on a line.
I know. Right, I've been reading about it.
You're going to be there, man. Like,
I think it's been long enough. I just...
I have to drag you.
Something broke in me, man.
Do you have a...
I couldn't...
TQ code? Because I have one for you if you need one. I might have a couple.
All right, we'll talk after this. I guess it's time to come back. I've been reading a bunch of good stuff, and the Z2 map looks pretty...
Well, we're not getting that yet.
I know, they have it in KOTK,
right? Not getting that yet, but like we're playing on a server that's decent.
I heard that we're not on Tranquility anymore. What the fuck?
No, we're on Tranquility. That's our server. We own it.
Havoc was telling me. All right, never mind.
So Bill and Miller are like, okay, what the hell are they talking about?
No, we've played H1Z1 back. I think Mill would actually enjoy playing/watching some H1Z1.
It's fun. I mean, I put like it's 1,000 great. Hours in and
it's
six
funny
months.
When Gina gets mad, though.
Oh, yeah. It's even funnier hearing Gina on... yeah, like through... Was it through... through Holder's kind of mic?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Gina, what...
That's even...
Well, I got this morning. Gina wants to talk to you. She's just going to talk to you. On my account. so Bill
like,
and Mill.
I remember I was there having a conversation with like Holder, and then I just hear Gina like just
pipe
like,
in.
Lay into somebody in the background, and I'm like, oh my god, whoever that is getting an earful. Like seriously.
So Bill and Mill, do you know? I don't even know if you know, but Bill, you probably know because you're in some of the conversations. So you know, TMC has its own gaming group. Where we play lots of different games, right? There's Archage, which little heads up, we're going to have Boat on next week. For those of you who are looking for Boat today, Boat's going to be on our show next week. He's going to talk about some of the exploits they've been doing in Archage. But there's just like CSGO, Archage. I mean, there's just so many games out there. There's a strategy game channel. There's everything in the Discord. So click on the upper right-hand corner of themitani.com and just join the Discord. And then we'll get you access to all the stuff that you need. But if you want to play H1 with us, right, there's going to be a big server wipe this week sometime. We just found out today.
So everyone's starting fresh?
Everybody starts fresh, and everybody runs to grab land on wipe day. As soon as the servers come up, you know, everybody's team comes in, and they get their job, and they go.
So Tranquility is PvP as well?
Tranquility is no different than a public server other than myself, McCloud, Spanx, Queez, and Milk and Cookies all admin the server. So we actually look for hackers and ban them from our server.
How many people are on the server at once?
I think we've had 150, 200 people almost. right at the limit.
We've had, like, on our last wipe, it was the, if not busier than most public servers.
Yeah.
Nice.
It is one of the most popular servers. I am getting hounded every day, in fact. So I've kind of taken over for Spanx. McLeod, I'm not letting him go anywhere. I need his help because he's a great guy. Lash, I need him back. Milk, I beg today. So Milk's coming back, Lash, today. And so we've got a lot of good people.
It's all right. I'm tired of my kids anyway. See, so this works out. Fucking
Dad, Daddy, we want food.
Get your own food. If you can speak English, you can get food. All right.
Need that.
There's food out there.
Okay. So
go get
refrigerator.
So now's the big wipe, and all the clans come back. I mean, we have entire clans pestering me for keys for their whole clan to come into to H1Z1 on the TQ server. Nice. I mean, the bases that are out there are just huge.
They're insane.
So
I watched a crazy fight this weekend at one of those bases, and it, like, I mean, you know what sort of base raiding's like sometimes, Lashauna. It can take a while. This one was about 5 hours, 5-6 hours worth of stuff.
Yeah, it kept going on and on.
Core.
Crazy.
And it came to a point where Wiz, the one clan that had been attacked, encircled one of their main bases. The attackers put up a whole bunch of bases, and they just kind of hell camped them for an hour, and we're working on them. It was fun to watch. As admin, you kind of get to watch some of this stuff, and it's really cool.
It was a Herculean task, man. It was insane.
They put a lot of planning into this, and what we'll talk about.
I just want to say, so when I played, like, right when it released, and the base building was, you could just build, like, little outhouse shacks. I assume that it's gone a lot further than that now, and you can actually, like, build legit shit.
They have a ways to go in what I think should be the real base building. But, yeah, there are people who are putting ground tamps down 4, 5, 10, 15, 20, and just making giant bases on them.
You can, like, trap it all and everything, too, so it's hard to blow up or whatever.
Yeah, you can do a whole bunch of stuff in there.
I'm just so out of the loop that I have no fucking idea, so just trying to ask questions before I come in there and get wrecked.
I think McLeod was trying to figure out how to make a nice big base today because I hadn't really told anybody to do it, and he just decided he wanted to do it. I have that feeling. I don't know that for sure.
I was looking into it. I've been sort of learning some interesting aspects of base building in H1Z1. Like, you know, I'm fairly well versed in it, but there's some interesting stuff that you kind of learn from either participating or watching a fairly large base raid, that you can incorporate a lot of stuff that makes fighting for and inside of a base really kind of really interesting.
Yeah.
Do you try and like build them around the houses that are in game, or just like out in the open in woods and shit?
Actually, Billy, you wouldn't know this yet, but like our server is it's got some particular rule set that's called limited build base building, POI base building, and essentially what that means is you can't build around or near to large places, points of interest.
Gotcha.
Most of those points of interest are buildings, so you can't, you know, like surround an entire building or a group of buildings anymore.
Reason being, people, myself included, would completely block off access to, you know, the only like fertilizer spawn, so nobody could make bombs on the server, and people would just leave the server.
Yeah,
it's a tactic.
We actually had the most perfectly placed Epic Governor's Mansion walling off of the garage because the garage was somehow outside of the POI restriction, right? And we had almost perfectly up against walled off the entire garage, which gave us a vehicle spawn that we controlled and gave us, like, what, 10, 12 cars that we could loot for metal and everything.
Loot for scrap. For scrap metal all the time.
Nobody could really come in and attack us when we were inside that unless they came through our base, which was terrible to get through.
Yeah.
And it's still there right now. But to get on TQ, you need special server keys that we control. So Daybreak gives us server keys, and we do it, and we have a limited number available that we'll probably be dishing out soon, as soon as I can talk to the team.
Yeah, to the web.
But if you two need one, right, I'll give you one.
Another question. How are the zombies? Are they a threat at all, or is it just like kind of an afterthought?
I was on one of the test servers today, and they seem to be a lot more zombies. Have you been on one, McCloud?
I've been sort of just, fleetingly, but yeah, they're pretty good. There's some new zombie types as well that you wouldn't know of, Bill. So like,
the screamer. Yeah, those ones are particularly awful.
Yeah, those ones will scare screamer will scare the crap out of you initially. You'll get kind of
like a witch or something from Left 4 Dead.
Very similar to a witch, but her scream. So you get within proximity of her. And her scream will stun you, and basically the only way to get out of it is to kill her. But her damage resistance gets progressively higher as you're trying to kill her, and it's almost a Sisyphean task. Like, unless you're heavily armed or with friends, you're gonna die.
Damn, so, that's
you,
cool.
If you don't have if you don't have a decent amount of ammo or some good amount of Molotovs, if you get stunned by the scream when there's a bunch of zombies around, like, you're pretty much toast.
Yeah.
Yeah, and cause she has scared the shit out of me more than once.
Just, no! That sound.
Oh, I mean, it's a scream. It's a scary scream. And the other thing that you can do is, if you kill one, right, you can extract their blood. And if you have the broken sonic grenade from the military camp, you can then make a screamer grenade. Which is a grenade that throw will scream and will attract all the zombies to it.
Well, it has the same stun effect as like the Banshee Call as well. So like it'll stun players and like cause them to walk instead of run.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah, so it's and then in this wipe, I think they're putting in the new ammunition changes, right, McCloud?
Yeah.
So it used to be you could collect ammunition, you could break it down. It breaks down one for one, and then it's a two for one to reconstitute any ammo type that you wanted. But what they're going to do now is you can't break down ammo anymore. It's whatever you find is whatever you get. So if you get...
Can you make ammo?
Not anymore.
No, at first blush, that seems stupid, but the problem is that people would just, goon that, and there would be tens of thousands. I mean, I remember one wipe in Deeds, we had upwards of 10,000 rounds, which is a lot of fun if you have it, but if you're facing us, there's no way you're going to win, because we could just throw all the ammo at you.
Especially when we can convert that all into shotgun and 308 rounds, right?
Yeah.
So, the most devastating rounds. Whereas, on the next wipe, it'll be a case of
shooting fucking
grenades. You get a whole bunch of 9mm, like, you best be good with a 9mm.
Yeah.
So does it just respawn like really gradually, or?
Yes, and it's based on population of the server and proximity of people to that spawn point, and it's balanced. They're just trying to make it a little bit more reasonable, because it was turning into these epic pitched battles of battalion sized elements of people with brigade sized elements of ammunition and supplies, and it just made no sense for an apocalypse. So. All right, so Mill, what did you buy for Steam? What did you get for the summer sale?
She's still on Pocket Card Jockey. I'm gonna talk
to
her.
Oh my god, woman. It's been a month.
Time to move on.
I can't help it.
All her horses are named after Harry Potter.
Yeah.
Oh dear,
that doesn't surprise me after the pictures I saw this weekend.
That's true.
A game for me.
Yeah, we bought one game on Steam called, well, we like to play the horror games, so we bought this game called Co-Lot. There was a...
We played it.
Do you want to talk about it?
Nope.
Yeah,
it was really stupid.
Go on.
So there's this movie, and it was called Devil's Pass, and it was basically, there was some like weird experiment in Russia in some mountain, I guess like the Ural Mountain range or whatever.
It wasn't an experiment. It was just like hikers
True. So I guess hikers stumbled in this like haunted mountain area, and they all like died, and everyone was like trying to figure out what happened. And basically, they made a video game based off the movie. Was this a true story?
It's a true story.
Based off the true story. So we were playing the video game, and it's kind of like they just throw you in this scenario with, and you don't know what the fuck you're doing. So we're just like running around doing stuff. There was like weird aliens and.
And you can only run for like 2 seconds, so it's really boring.
But hey, I'm not the one who wanted to buy it. That was her choice.
Looked but, better than it was.
Yeah, other than that, I guess I haven't really played anything else I bought. I talked last week about this game, Salt and Sanctuary. It's almost seems like a 2D Dark Souls, so I'm excited to play that.
2D Dark Souls, man. Hmm. That sounds... kill yourself awful, but I'm sure it's fun.
Yeah, I've just been waiting to play. I finally got a cord to hook my Xbox One controller up to the PC so I can use that, and then I'm gonna try and play that using that. But other than that, we didn't really buy too much. I do want to mention this weekend, last Splatfest ever for Splatoon. So, Lash, if you haven't already, go out and buy Splatoon for your Wii U.
Okay.
Add us on Nintendo, and let's just fucking frag all day Saturday.
Okay. I'm down. That sounds lovely.
You know, one of the...
Have you been using the Wii?
Oh, go ahead. Finish up. I'll say it next.
Oh, sorry. Have you been playing Wii U lately? Because I know you got one.
I did 2 weeks of Army and then 1 week of vacation, so I have been doing nothing fun.
So the wife was probably killing it on there while you were gone.
I am certain that I have at least 2 or 3 more unlocked Mario Kart characters. So I'm excited about that.
Excellent.
She gets on that baby Peach and it's a wrap, son.
I like Mario Kart. It's a fun game.
Yeah.
Mario Kart's so classic.
I can't go wrong. If you're not throwing shells at something, what are you doing with your life? So, all right, well, so then, Mr. McLeod, what did you get?
I mean, like, I didn't actually... Actually, I tell a lie. I got Planetary Annihilation.
Oh!
I wanted to get it for a long time.
Throwback.
Yeah. Well, it's kind of like, yeah, throwback to the old RTS.
Total. It's Total Annihilation, right? Yeah.
Which is just, like, so baller in the day, you know?
Yes, I know! It's revolutionary.
I know, man. Like, I mean, that's... Like, people kind of think that they're all cool and everything when they say, yeah, I used to play, like, Command & Conquer and stuff. Exactly. And it's like, nah, you ain't
you don't even know, son.
Because that's so generic and that's so mainstream. Like, you know, play Total Annihilation. That's what you play if you were cool.
Have you played it a lot yet?
I played it a fair amount. It can be quite difficult. It's like... It's one of those classic things where if you put it on easy, it's actually really easy. But like, as soon as you put it like anywhere past easy, it's like
you gang bang by
everyone. I swear to God, it like practically cheats.
Literally, it's like Civ 5 on dating.
I find it really fun. Like it's really interesting to play on something that isn't just a flat map that has edges and stuff like that. It's really interesting to play on maps that are entirely spherical. Like, mm-hmm. And being able to sort of, you know, fly to different planets and set up different colonies and, you know, create wormholes between the two and, like, you know, build a, like, take a moon and build a whole bunch of engines on it and just throw it and smash it into you know, another planet, that kind of thing. It's amazing.
Okay, I'm buying.
Have you tried like multiplayer or just going against bots for now?
I've just been going against bots for the most part. I hear that you like even just playing against bots. Like if you're playing against bots or even if you're playing against people, like the whole thing it records the whole thing, so you can actually you can essentially just once the game ends, you can replay the entire thing. Like from start to finish and see what happened and see what was going on and this, that, and the other. So it's pretty awesome.
Now I know I haven't bought it yet. Why does it have mixed reviews? What is not positive about this game?
I'm not too sure. Like,
so you would sign off on it, suggest it.
I'd sign off on it, but I haven't been playing a massive amount of it. So, like, I imagine, you know, some people kind of have been playing it for a little while. And
did you get Titans?
I didn't get Titans. I'm kind of wanting to get Titans.
Okay, Titans is
Titans.
Well, I don't know. That's the other. That has very positive reviews. It's the single player update that gets like 60%.
Maybe that was what was missing from it. Maybe people were expecting there to be. Well, actually, yeah, fair enough. Like, because before you used to in Total Annihilation, you used to get all those massive like robots, the Kogoth or whatever it was. Mm-hmm. I guess a lot of people
wanted that.
I was gonna come back, and when there wasn't, they would kind of go a bit pissy with it.
Fair enough. Well,
but, the Titan, you know, Titans basically is that times four or five. So, you know, I guess that's the case.
It looks awesome.
Sean's gone into night mode.
I sent a message to my wife. She left. She didn't leave any lights on downstairs. And
it actually looks pretty cool.
I don't know. It works. I'm thinking about leaving her. She's kind of awful. Like, she also is like, buy me things. And I'm like, you have money. So where does this leave us? Anyways, not important, not relevant. All right, Planetary Annihilation, Titans. I'll get it, Roger.
Definitely play a few games with you, man. That'd be amazing. The one game which I've actually been humming and hawing about, like, just purely from a, like, a cost perspective sort of thing, because I'm a type motherfucker. but I've been watching videos of it, like, again and again and again, and it's just a case of I don't know other people who own it, so
yeah,
I'd really like more than just me to own it, but I really want to get GTA 5 just because of the huge amount of like hilarious moments that occur with it, like, in it.
How do you not know anybody that I own it? It's fantastic.
Yes.
Yeah, man, holy shit, dude. It's I mean, all right, so I never really got into the online scene, but the single player alone is just, it's the best GTA ever.
I've just seen so many hilariously comical.
Oh yeah, no, the fucking Reddit
moments to it that I want to be part of that. I want that.
I want it in my life. I want a jet to land on my face while I'm trying to jump off a bridge on a motorcycle. Like, oh my god, yes. Why is this not in my life already? Holy fuck. Someone drop what I'm doing and get a jet to land on my face while I'm trying to jump off a bridge on a motorcycle. Yeah, no, I agree. And from time to time, I feel drawn back to it. And then, actually, I was texting a buddy just the other day. I was driving down the road, and Eminence Front came on the radio, and I can't hear that song and not think of San Andreas. And, you know, like Flock of Seagulls with Vice City. Like, games are just have imprinted themselves on our, you know, I don't know, yeah. Social fabric. They're just awesome.
Persona and everything, man.
Yeah. And yes, there are heists and craziness.
Like, the last GTA I played was probably Vice City, and I absolutely adored that game, man. Like,
oh, Vice City. I think Mill even knows Vice City.
Yeah, I played that.
In the rain.
The radio was great in Vice City.
Yes.
The
radio
was
amazing in Vice City. Oh, my God.
It's so funny playing it now, because, like, the buildings are literally, like, blocks, and you just, like, zoom around everywhere, like, so fucking fast.
Oh, my God.
Everything. It was like you could have, like, all the police and army on you and everything, and you just, you know, drive into one of those, like, spray-and-go kind of things, and it's just, like, it's kind of like
Clark Kent and Superman. What do you want?
Like, nope, I'm a completely different person.
Criminal fucking mastermind. Give us the slip again. And it's great because you'll drive in and then you'll drive out and they're like parked right outside. There's like 55 of them. And
yeah, like, have you seen this guy? He was driving a car exactly like yours, but just a different color. No, I ain't seen him.
Yeah, and you know, the great thing about our new Discord is you just throw in general, hey, I'm playing this game. Anybody want to play?
Yeah,
for those who were bored and said, hey, I didn't know anybody to play it with, right, McLeod? So it's one of the things in the Imperium, which we can do.
Because I think especially with goons being goons, like we could have some insanely hilarious moments in that game.
Let's do it, McLeod.
Like as a group.
There you go.
You've just motivated me so much. So I missed your face. I missed your voice.
See, Billy's the perfect temperament to become like Imperium goonish guy. He's right on the edge. He's ready. He's primed.
I see a fair amount of evil in Mill that we can distill, purify, and turn into delicious evilness.
I just didn't really want to call her a goon. Really. No.
By the way, that should be a unified thing on the whole of TMC Twitch, that if anybody says twist the knife, you have to drink. So there you go. Have to drink.
Gotta drink.
Yeah, I guess we're drinking.
Mad for a beer. And my wife doesn't care. And I'm sitting in the dark. And my dog needs to go out. And my kids are probably still awake.
I still gotta say my favorite skin that we've gotten is in H1Z1, where we have the His Regards machete. The Mitanni sends his regards. I just love it.
It still doesn't melt.
That's awesome. That's good. That's an extra fuck you, because machetes were nice at one point. You know, you get two metal bars out of it, like, oh well, at least I got these two metal bars to start my life again after the fucking Imperium rolled through and shit in my time wasting mouth.
That's right. And they stick but it in there and it doesn't melt, and we've got a pack. We leave him a His Regards machete when we raided a base. We take everything, leave that, and leave a packet of salt.
Yeah.
Whoa, is that me giving the feedback there? Maybe Mike's too close?
No,
that was me.
I don't know. No, I think it was me.
Oh, okay. He's playing the bottle.
So I got a topic.
Lustreve, Mitanni's not here drinking with us. Sorry, but yes, he drinks the tears of our enemies. I have an interesting meme that is so bad and so evil that we made an Exe related to the tears of our enemy, and it's so bad we won't even expose it to the general public.
That bad? It's really
bad. That's all I'm going to say. I'm not going to... No more hints, nothing.
That's it.
So do you guys want to know what I bought on the sale?
So I
realized that the Kerbal Space Program that I got long ago was just like a trial version or something, so I bought Kerbal. The whole shit.
Oh, man. Dude, I've been playing that since 0.22, and my wife has been making fun of me since 0.22. And she always, like, she'll see me playing. I'll play it in bed. She's watching her show. I'm playing that. And she's like, are you killing fucking Kermie again? Are you leaving him on the moon to die? I'm like, Elizabeth, I'm sending a mission right now. We're going to get him back. It's going to be okay. Invariably, it's not okay. Invariably, Kermies are on the moon.
Is this the game, Lash, that like you use so you can basically say, I'm a scientist, goddammit?
I'm doing science on the moon right now, bitch.
Science.
Hey, Lustreve, I mean, all our names are right underneath us. That's like right there. I'm Eric. There's McLeod. Oh, the other side. McLeod. You know, we Lash, Mill, and Bill. We don't have the Mitanni. I don't know which one of us sounds like mittens.
Vaporize makes me very angry.
Yes. So anyhow, I killed Valentina this weekend. She's dead.
Dude, she's not the primary. How do you go through Jebediah and
she was just in there.
That sounds pretty misogynistic, Eric.
Well, the rocket was a little too heavy and didn't have the right decouplers, and the parachute didn't slow her down enough. And she died.
Damn.
I don't know if we get like another one later, but yeah.
No, she's donezo. You get Valentinia, Ilya. I mean, you get some
now
different versions.
The others are in orbit forever.
Yeah, I got one checking out the sun forever. you stay there. You think about what you did.
So yeah, I was just building. I was on, you know, sandbox mode and just building the most insane ships that I could.
I wonder if Kerbal will ever do like a Kerbal sort of SpaceX expansion where you have to land your rocket onto the water.
There are several pretty awesome streamers that will do real life stuff, you know, try to equate it to as much as possible. That game is fantastic, but I don't know how much you follow the, you know, r/gaming or whatever. Apparently Squad were like slave laboring their people and not paying shit. And they
what did the like first person combat game.
No. Squad, the people that made
Make Kerbal.
Yeah. They were not paying their basically the vast majority of their staff shit. And they got in a lot of trouble for it.
It was performance pay. They had to get perfect landings and perfect.
No, they had all those Kerbals that were stranding in space and on the moon, they had to go rescue them. The help desk was really busy.
You get them back to Earth safely, yeah. Then you get $100 and that kind of thing.
I'm going to be a broke man, but...
Hey, Cassandra, darn.
You can understand why they weren't really paid that much then.
It's fucking hard, man. It's hard. Okay?
I don't doubt it.
So can we bring up a new topic?
You can bring up any topic that you want, man. Just butt in and do it. Go on.
So, did you guys see, there was like a Reddit post recently. I don't know if you've ever watched any H3 Productions videos before, but he did a gaming one, I guess, this past week, and it was about CSGO skin gambling.
Oh, yeah. It's one of our topics, yeah.
So, he pretty much exposed, I guess, two big streamers who I randomly just see playing COD. Cass, it's right here, by the way. And pretty much, like, I guess it's fucked up because they're promoting this skin gambling site and they own the site itself.
Yeah, and they acted like they had just gambled and won and showed videos of them gambling and winning. And they didn't tell anybody that they owned it.
Yeah, and then they do all the retroactive shit, like, oh, this has been public information, and then, you know, they go back and play the video. It's like, oh, I found this sweet new site, CSGOLotto.com. Yeah, I follow them on Twitter.
In actual fact, they even say that, like, we're kind of talking with them, and, like, hopefully we're going to get, like, you know, sponsored by them at some point. Like, it's your own company, you idiot.
Oprah, Harpo.
Well, you know, there's no problem with gambling in gaming. It's okay. Don't worry.
Well, there's no problem with gambling, but like it's gambling. Yeah. So
when it falls under gambling laws,
it needs to be regulated. And the other thing is, like, as far as they're concerned, like 9-year-olds, 8-year-olds can, you know, are perfectly fine for playing and gambling. Like, and that is a serious issue. Because all of those things can be redeemed through Steam transactions into money.
Yeah, so, I was trying to explain this to Mill, and I was like, it's not real money, but it is if you go to, like, third-party stuff. Or, like, some little kid gets his parents' credit card, watches these YouTube videos, because I feel like the younger generation is much more into YouTube. Like, my little cousins are like, oh, you know this YouTuber? I'm like, I have no idea who the fuck that is. But they definitely watch these people, and they see them just gambling skins that you can get. So, you know, you get people getting their parents' credit cards, buying skins, and going to these sites and just gambling them away. And
he's a youth today.
Yeah, that's where you get your nephews.
Can be my daughter.
Twitch. What's this YouTube shit? Jesus, Jonathan, get with the YouTube program. YouTube's like... I don't know, that's for Generation X. Grow up. Go with the Twitch.
Yeah, I don't know.
Tell me you're a big Twitch star.
I'm huge on Twitch.
Roseanne Barr asked to play with my dog. I am a big star. God damn it.
Rosie O'Donnell,
whatever. Yeah. Roseanne Barr, Rosie O'Donnell. They're like
in the show.
The same.
He was they're right.
Like evil Fox twin and separated at birth or something.
That's true. I can't hear her. Wait. Oh, wait a minute. No, those are two different people. Roseanne Barr and Rosie O'Donnell. Holy shit.
Yeah, because they have.
Fucking brain just exploded, man.
It's like a jet commercial. Did you guys see the purple smoke come out of his head? No, it's too dark there. I can't see it. I was like.
Jesus. Be quiet.
Oh, God.
I don't want to talk. I need an adult. Okay. Five more minutes of the show. I can do this.
5 minutes. No, we only got 5 minutes left. This is where we remind everybody, if you haven't followed us here at TMC, please shoot us a follow. If you'd like to donate to the stream, please do so. Just mention my name, and I'll make sure this stream gets a donation. And, you know, if you'd like to become a subscriber here at TMC, you know, by all means, you're welcome to do that. None of that is absolutely required. Well, we do really like to see the follows, absolutely. But if you so choose to support us monetarily, you know, we welcome you to do so, you know.
You're also more likely to win prizes and handouts and stuff because typically they're mod kind of, subscriber only kind of stuff as well. So.
Mill.
Yep, and we're trying to get some stuff. And, you know.
Mill.
No. I don't want to throw you under the bus.
Uh-oh.
But.
What bus?
While I was crawling through the woods a few weeks ago, I was talking to my buddy about this show and the online
and
stuff.
The bugs and the rain.
And the bugs and the glaven. And did you ever get Jeopardy together?
Oh, shoot.
I was so excited. So excited.
Are you so excited?
I was so excited. I didn't have much to be excited about. And
don't worry,
now I have
I'll
nothing to be excited about.
Could you just...
I think I'm going to have to help her with a Jeopardy, get some questions.
Just, do you have a cattle prod? Because if you don't, I can lend you mine.
there's nowhere we can go with that that's remotely legal.
Sorry, I'll shut up.
We'll have to check Mark Conius's new rules of streaming and see if you're allowed to even mention that anymore. I'm going to check that out.
Oh, God. But yeah, yes. I think, I guess we have a better idea of, like, what gaming stuff people are into, because I thought people would be really, on the show, would be, like, they know, like, the classic shit, like Zelda, Nintendo. I guess we were just basically, because Nintendo's, like, you know, you grow up with, like, Nintendo and Sega, but yeah. I feel like some of the people we've talked to have no idea what the fuck we're talking about. So we might have to do like more recent stuff than the old stuff. No, maybe we'll make the old stuff the harder, the more money questions.
Running out of alcohol.
Billy, how old are you?
I just turned 27 on Friday.
Okay, see, I would even think you were young to know that stuff. Like, I'm 32, you know, Nintendo, I grew up with a Nintendo, like, in my room. Like, you're 27, you must have had, what, Super Nintendo?
I had Sega Genesis, and yeah, my one buddy down the street had Super Nintendo. I did play, like, Paperboy on Nintendo a lot, too.
Paperboy. Yes. That fucking dog.
I had, like, a...
Son of a bitch would come out of nowhere. Like, look, bitch, you just came out of a trash can. I'm calling fucking bullshit on this game right now.
I had, like, a fucking 13-inch black and white TV with the little turny knobs and six fucking channels, and two of them were UHF.
UHF, VHF.
And I had I had like the Radio Shack glorified Pong with the little fucking paddles, you know. When you played doubles, it was like a big deal. Yeah. My God.
I think Mill had track for NES too. You had track and field, right?
I did.
With you pads. Have the pad? Yeah. And you'd have that one asshole that would jump off the pad and then jump back on, like, all right, fucking Billy, cut it out. Not you, Billy, one. Like, you know, my growing up friend, Billy.
Billy!
Billy.
That Billy.
I mean, surely we can find an online version of track and field that we can play, like, in streams and stuff.
Oh, yeah, we should. Yeah, we should.
That would be great.
That would be awesome.
We're going to investigate some neat things to do.
Mm.
Hey, well, we're down to our last less than a minute here. I want to thank everybody in the chat for joining in. Thank you, guys. We love having you there in your interaction. And anytime you want to redirect the conversation that you hear us talking about, just shoot right in and say, hey, what do you guys think about X? And we'll talk about it and we'll engage. Atari 64, love it, Wiz. And you know, and be sure to check out our sponsor, digitalblasphemy.com. And I want to thank everybody for being on the panel today. I really enjoy when you guys come in, and we're going to have a couple people who are on vacation. It's coming up on the summer, and then we have a couple people coming back from a little break from the game. I think next week, I think we're going to have Milk back here, and Milk hasn't actually been on yet, so we'll have Milklash.
Yay!
Spank said he's going to come in, and we're going to have next week, we're going to have Boat on the show.
So nice.
He's come on.
Damn, so, nice. The Boat?
We're going to have Boat. He's going to be here.
Wow. Damn.
I hope he brings a hat. I like the hat.
The Boat Mountain.
All right.
I might have to bring a hat, too.
From all of us here at TMC, we wish everybody good evening, and I think .com is coming up next. And have a good evening, and we'll see you here next week.
Thank you.
Bye.
Goodbye. Bye.